This month, the Chicago mayor's race begins in earnest, and already the field is narrowing. Former White House Chief of Staff Rahm Emanuel is the early frontrunner. And after a few high-profile withdrawals from the race, former U.S. Senator Carol Moseley Braun has emerged as the only major African-American candidate. Reverend Jesse Jackson is the president of the Rainbow Push Coalition based in Chicago. Reverend, good to see you today.
Happy New Year.
So how important is this next mayor to Chicago's future?
You know, it's a big deal because Chicago has such a tremendous imbalance in employment and contracts and public education and public transportation. Chicago has been built so strongly around a central downtown Chicago. But out in the district where President Barack Obama was the organizer, it's 30% unemployment, record-breaking home foreclosures. And you look at the distribution of jobs and contracts, there's just imbalance. And so we worked diligently to get someone who could head a coalition of conscience. And Carol Moseley Braun has run three times and won Chicago. A 50-ward candidate, she has been recorded of deeds. She ran and won twice as U.S. Senator. And so her credentials with the Big Tent vision are substantial.
Okay, so you have gotten the credit now for some of the backroom wheeling and dealing that convinced the other two African-American candidates here to exit the race, Representative Danny Davis and State Senator James Meeks. In the most recent poll, Reverend, they were running ahead in terms of support ahead of Carol Moseley Braun. In your mind, what makes her the better candidate than those other two?
I think when they looked at the broad scope, you have to have a message with their sham message and money and machinery. She was able to attract a broad base of resources. And they determined at the end of the day that all three felt they were qualified, but only one could run and win. And just as it seemed that Mr. Sheriff Dodd decided he would not run against Rahm Emanuel, and just as in the past when Mr. Daley and Jane Brennan ran against each other, Harold Walsh emerged. And so we decided to try to solidify a candidate who embodied the message and the values of the broad-based coalition. And Carol, having won three times, ran for Congress and won, but she is the only one who has run the citywide and won three times. So we know she's formidable. But I submit to you the crisis that we have now is that the level, we started a campaign at Rainbow Push last week of asking all those who are searching for jobs to bring their resumes. Over 1,000 people in 2 days came up. People are desperate for jobs, yeah. And so fair access to jobs and contracts is a big deal for us, Contessa.
A lot of the problems that Chicago faces are mirrored in other big cities around the nation. So it's understandable that whoever wins this race has a major challenge ahead of them. To that end, there's been a lot of talk about who's an outsider, who really knows Chicago, who's been away for too long. And Carol Moseley Braun warned former President Bill Clinton not to come into town and campaign for Rahm Emanuel. She said, Bill Clinton is an outsider parachuting in to support another outsider. He should stay home and avoid the cold. Does Bill Clinton risk his relationship with the African-American community if he comes in and campaigns for the person he thinks is best for this job, and it happens to be Rahm Emanuel?
Well, I hope not. I think people are disappointed, but this should not be a distraction. I remember when Harold was running in 83 that Senator Kennedy and Mondale came in to support Jane Brennan and Daley. We were disappointed in them making that choice. And if Mondale and Kennedy had been successful in crushing Harold Washington, a whole floor of history may have been altered because Harold did win. And I ran in 84 and put on 2 million new voters. That gave us the Senate back in 86. 88, we got proportionality. Out of that came the voter surge for Carol Moseley Braun and now President Barack Obama. A whole floor of history was kind of depending upon our success in 83. And so today, there are those who appeal to President Clinton, please don't come in. But it's his choice. And I think his comment should be accepted for what it is, but it should not distract us from the urban policy agenda. Right now, we have an urban policy agenda deficit, and that's our real focus. We need an urban policy, and right now we really don't have a comprehensive one.
Reverend Jackson, it's always a pleasure to talk to you. A nice way to kick off the new year. Happy New Year, sir.
Same to you. Thank you.